The latest in two Des Moines shootings, one happened overnight. Good afternoon and thank you for joining us. Des Moines police are working on two shootings within five blocks in less than 26 hours.
One turned deadly. News Channel 8's Molly Nelson has more on our top story this afternoon. Molly?
In the latest shooting, several shots were heard, and then one man says he was hit in the leg early this morning. A friend drove that man, Mr. Jackman, to Broadlands Medical Center around 2 a.m. Jackman told police that he was shot outside his home at 21st and Forest. You're seeing it here. He says that he couldn't describe the shooter. An officer patrolling the area did hear the 5 to 6 shots around the same time. Police discovered 2 bullets in the street and bullet holes in the door and the window of Jackman's home. The other shooting happened early Wednesday morning about 5 blocks away at 16th and Carpenter Avenue, that is near Evelyn Davis Park. 30-year-old Daryl Kinchlow was killed. Another man, age 18, was injured in release. Both men lived in the area. Police were called to this shooting just after 12 a.m. They believe that it stemmed from a feud that was happening between 2 groups that started Friday. Both victims were found outside, and police say several people, maybe 8 to 10, were in the area, and they're questioning several of those witnesses. They still hope to talk to these 2 people. They've issued material witness warrants for 35-year-old Michael Wells and 20-year-old Derek Smith, but they are not calling them suspects at this time. No arrests have been made in either shooting. Both did happen near the Evelyn Davis Park, a spot that has seen a lot of violence during the nighttime.
All right, Molly, we know that neighborhood leaders met last night. What are their plans?
Well, they had some different ideas. Some talked about perhaps a citywide curfew. Well, state lawmaker Wayne Ford talked about more jobs being needed for the area. He says if there were more jobs, there would be fewer people on the streets at night.
Molly Nelson, thank you very much.